Hi everyone and welcome on my living room floor. This is one of the larger projects that I did and it is for my mom actually, because she wanted to have a new painting to hang over her sofa and this is the one to be, I hope. The colors that I'm going to use is a light gray, white, black and pink, which resemble the colors that my parents have in their living room, and so this is my go-to colors as well. My plan for this is again my 5-cup tool, but in a marble look. So I do not want to have the design look that I usually go for when I use the cup tool, so the 3 or 5 cup tool. This one was supposed to be looking like it was a slice of marble with, well, these colors. Technique-wise, it is pretty much the same approach as for the ring look that you have seen in so many other projects already, but it's a bit different in tilting. I have never tried this technique on such a large canvas before. I did a marble canvas for one of my neighbors about 1.5 years back or so, which looked great. It was a different approach in technique, so let's just see how this one turns out. As this is a really large canvas, I am making a base layer coat of white paint. This is just acrylic paint mixed with my acrylic binder. It's a bit thinner than the usual mix that I used to pour with. And it is, meant to cover the canvas just to allow the paint to flow easier. Before I started prepping my canvas, I made the cup tool full with paint. I actually had no really idea how much paint I'm going to need and how much of each color I'm going to need. As the major color was supposed to be the gray, I used this one of course for the outer ring, as this can hold most of the paint, and added all the other colors that I had available in the other cups. At this point everything was pretty much experimental, and after this was done I used the rest amount of the gray that I had available and some of the white and painted the background base layer. When the preparation was done, it was time to start the paint pouring. To allow the paint to flow over the canvas easier, I elevated it from one side just a bit. How much you tilt the canvas depends of course how quickly your paint is running. This is, your own taste. I cannot really give so much recommendation there. I normally just follow my gut feeling on how much to tilt there. And then it is just pouring the paint out of your pouring cup and hoping for the best. And although the first seconds look pretty interesting and promising, all was lost after a couple seconds more. I don't really know what happened there, if the gray was probably too thin, but it overpowered the entire thing. So the black was almost gone and the purple did not even get a chance to shine. So when all the paint was poured out, as you can see, it pretty much was pretty gray. There was just a thin stream of the white covering the entire canvas and a slight hint of the pink. So I couldn't do anything else than just mixing my paints again and giving it another try. Said and done. I mixed up my colors. I did not film it here, so I just cut this one out and refilled my cup. I did add less of the gray this time because there was already so much on the canvas. I added more of the black, more of the pink and a bit more of the white. I also put the paints pretty random in my pouring cup, so I did not even fill each ring with one separate color. I mixed them in between and layered them within each of the rings, just to give each of the paint a chance to shine. I started pouring again, and this time at least I had some more paint and colors on my canvas, and each of the colors had a chance to come through. To give this more like a marble effect, I moved my pouring cup to each side just to change the design and how the colors behaved. I stretched them around, and again a marble look was the goal to achieve. So I wanted these colors to kind of transition into each other, like a slice of stone might look like. And I think I pretty much achieved the look that I was going for. I perhaps hoped for a bit more of the black and pink to come through, but there was not so much that I could change on that end at this time of the pour. I was pretty happy though that the second attempt went in the direction that I wanted to get. And as usual, I hope this project and video was somewhat entertaining for you and probably even encouraged you to try something like that on your own if you want to go larger. Most of the pourings are on a smaller size, so going that large is always a bit tricky. It always stresses me out as well, so I'm not really used to go that large as well, and some turn out differently than others, as we all know. For this one, I'm pretty happy that I got the result that I have here. My mom really, really liked it. It fits perfectly in the living room, and as I missed filming the white result here and even the red result from close up, I just asked my mom to send me a photo of the picture hanging on the wall, and so that I can give you an impression how the finished result looks. Of course, the gray dried a little bit darker than you can see here, but not so much. The black remained black, and the pink is a metallic color, so it dried a bit shiny and a bit brighter than you can see here. And in the end, everything was varnished with the Liquitex Satin varnish. So it's not glossy, it's satin, and I think the satin made a perfect finish to the piece. So if you're new to my channel and liked what you've seen, please make sure to leave me a thumbs up, subscribe, have a look at my product list, which I've linked in the video description with the products that I have used. If you like to use my links, you can use the Arteza affiliate links with my coupon code, which you can find in the video description to get 10% off. And you can also use my Amazon links if you are from Germany, and this would of course both help me because you support my channel by clicking them. So if you want to get in touch with me, you can use my social media links, which you can also find down below. And if you have some spare space on your walls and need some paintings, you can also have a look at my Etsy store. So I think this is everything that I can advertise for me. And again, thank you so much for your time. Thank you for watching. And other than that, I hope to see you in my next video. Have a great day. Bye bye.